Blackstone presents Eat and Flourish, How Food Supports Emotional Well-Being by Mary Beth Albright. This book is read by Caroline Shaffer and Grover Gardner. For my sisters, Anne, who taught me that art and beauty are everywhere, Evelyn, who taught me the power of good mental health.
Foreword. As a chef and a physician, I have been standing at the intersection of food and well-being for more than 30 years. Until recently, it has been a fairly lonely corner, but thankfully that is changing. In the past decade, armed with mounting evidence that food and cooking can improve all aspects of health, I started a culinary medicine program, first at the Tulane School of Medicine and now at George Washington University School of Medicine and Health Sciences. This coursework, which has been adopted by universities across the nation, helps teach the benefits of nutrition-related lifestyle changes, such as cooking. In my quest to teach and use the important connection between well-being and food, I've been fortunate to meet amazing chefs, healthcare professionals, policymakers, researchers, and journalists who care deeply about great food as an important component of well-being. One of those journalists whom I met a few years back immediately impressed me as caring not just about this topic, but also about her craft. She is the author of the book you are now reading, Mary Beth Albright. Mary Beth and I met when she interviewed me for a profile about culinary medicine that she was writing for National Geographic. It was clear that she had done her homework and had established a solid foundation of knowledge about the subject. She delivered a terrific description of the state of the art at the time. She delivers again with this book. Food research has come a long, long way in the four decades that I have been involved in the nutrition world. This is the challenge that you, the reader, faces. Science evolves, and that means changes in recommendations around food and health. People are understandably confused because in one decade we are told to substitute margarine for butter, and a decade later, we're told that margarine has actually been contributing to health issues. The good news is that we now have a much more solid understanding of how what we eat can both harm us and benefit us. It can sometimes be hard to know what to believe. This book is one that you can trust and one you can believe. It is a solid review of the science and provides direct day-to-day application for your life and your health by showing the impact of one of the most important aspects of living longer and living well, how food supports your emotional well-being. Most of us think of diets or eating plans or nutrition as applying to the usual suspects, such as heart attacks, strokes, diabetes, hypertension, and high cholesterol. However, the same healthy food principles apply to our moods, emotions, pleasure, energy, and mental health. Mary Beth does an amazing job in leading us through the complex neurologic anatomy and hormone responses. Trust me, understanding neurotransmitters, endocrine responses, gamma-aminobutyric acid, dopamine, adrenocorticotropic hormone and cortisol activity is tough stuff even for healthcare professionals. Mary Beth makes understanding things such as the amygdala and hippocampus easy and even fun. And both of those brain structures are just fun to say out loud. This is because she has translated the hard stuff in a way that allows her to lead readers through the impact that food has on everything, from sights and sounds to pleasure and socialization, to name only a few stops on the journey she takes us on. That trip starts with a tour of the body itself, and she acts as the consummate tour guide.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.